Welcome to Maximal Being,
a podcast devoted to ditching fad diets and using real science to get you healthy and feeling great.
I'm Doc Mock, a GI and functional medicine doctor who harnesses the power of gut health to get you achieving your goals.
And I'm Jackie P, a well-informed layman who challenges the experts and asks the questions that you want.
Don't forget to hit the subscribe button or leave a comment.
And now, on to the show. Hello, hello, Maximal Beings. It is I, Jackie P. By now, I better be your favorite layman. If not, I will cry. I'm here with my co-hostess with the mostest, Doc Mock. Doc Mock, how are you today, sir?
I am great, Jackie. I'm stamping out cancer down here in Tampa in the sunshine. I just got out of the pool, actually.
Like, rub it in, why don't you?
Not beat that. Yeah, I mean, can't wait for you guys to come down and visit and enjoy our beautiful oasis that is our backyard. Life is good, man.
That's wonderful. You heard that, everyone? A beautiful oasis. I will put it to the test myself. Mm-hmm. And with me, we have Chief Executive Officer of Natural Cure Labs, right, operating as Palmera Health and Vitatales. Excuse me if I mispronounced that. Fellow Gator, hello, chomp chomp. I'm just going to call you Damon. Damon, you can tell the folks your last name because I don't want to do the disservice of mispronouncing it. Damon, how are you today?
I'm doing great, Jackie. Yep, Damon. Sununtnasuk is how you pronounce the last name, but Damon is totally fine. Chomp chomp.
Chomp chomp, yes. So we're talking today about, let's back up. Before we start talking about everyone who, if you're listening for the first time, I'm Jackie, your layman. I'm going to make sure that Damon and Doc Mock keep the conversation off of the jargon level, right? So I throw my flag, I whistle my, blow my whistle, and make sure that anyone who happens to stumble upon this fine podcast for the first time can keep up with us. Doc Mock?
I think I actually got to get you a whistle. I think that would be like perfect.
I should get it. Or like a weird horn. Sometimes it just
sounds like a big absurd, loud horn. I think that would be amazing. Yeah. Well, what's going on, Maximal Beings? Doc Mock here. I am a therapeutic endoscopist, which is a fancy type of GI doctor that works on cancers. I'm also a functional medicine provider practicing here in beautiful Tampa, Florida. Back to you, Jackie B.
Thank you, Jackie B. So before, I was excited because I'm very excited about this topic. You know, coconut oils and all these things are, it's all over any nutrition and fitness site. And I like that we're going to get down to the science and talk about it.
Paleo, keto, vegan, and carnivore. Maybe you've tried them all, but did you have success? Are you still doing that diet? Turns out there's not just one diet right for one particular person. By understanding how your body works and the relationship behind your body's workings and these diets, you can then approach the perfect plan for you. In the Perfect Human Diet course, we talk to you about your body's inner workings and the pros and cons of each plan. We discuss how our ancestors ate and have eaten and lay a framework to tailoring a plan that is perfect for you. To learn more about the Perfect Human Diet course, head to maximalbeing.com/courses to find out more. And as always, I'm Doc Mock, and I'm here to maximize your health. You cannot supplement your way to health, but there are things that we need to add to our lives that can maximize our pathway to wellness. The American diet is virtually devoid of omega-3 fatty acids, which play a major role in cardiovascular disease, gut permeability, and mental health. Personally, I take omega-3s every night, and iHerb is the best place for clean, natural sources of supplements. I love the ZenWise omega-3 fatty acid supplement, which is free of fish burps and good for the environment. Head on over to maximalbeing.com/iHerb, that's I-H-E-R-B, and enter the code B as in boy, D as in dog, B as in boy, 5528, and receive 10% off your orders for all supplements. Maximize your supplements with iHerb.
But before we get into that fun stuff, Damon, you know, myself, Doc Mock, and of course the wonderful people listening, we'd like to hear your origin story, right? How did you go from going to one of the greatest colleges of this nation to sitting here with us, you know, and talking about Monolaurin and supplements and gut health and all that stuff. So Damon, take it away.
Yeah, you got it, Jackie. Thanks for that kind intro. And it's not an exaggeration. I think Florida's number 5 right now, if I'm not mistaken. So
pretty, no big deal.
Great. Look, so the origin stories of the company Natural Cure Labs goes back to 2015. And I'm the founder of the company. And that's important because I had spent a significant amount of time overseas. I lived in Europe for several years. I lived in East Asia for several years. And I was fortunate enough to live in countries that provided me with access to social or universal healthcare, right? I'm originally from the US. And so after a few years overseas, I moved back and I moved to San Francisco. And for the first time in my adult life, really, I'd found myself really empathizing in a very real way with the 50 plus million Americans that don't have access to health insurance. I was at 29 million Americans who don't have access to health insurance, and the 58 million Americans who suffer from something called medication insecurity. They basically don't have access to the therapeutic drugs that they need to stay healthy. And I thought to myself, my goodness, something has to be done about this. Like, there has to be a better way. And browsing the shelves of your average CVS and Walgreens got me thinking, there's a lot of stuff out here that just doesn't make a lot of sense. It's not backed by research. It has some excipients or fillers that just maybe shouldn't be there, or maybe it's at a potency or a weight or level, dosing level, just not really going to move the needle. So I was sort of inspired by the entrepreneurial spirit of San Francisco at the time, and thought, let's do something about this. Let's make an accessible, quality-driven, research-based supplement company that can really help people in similar situations. That's how we got started.
Amazing.
Yeah, that's so you see that? Damon saw the change that needed to be made, and he was like, I'm gonna be the change, right, folks? A little life lesson out there for you. Sorry, I'm feeling philosophical today, so there's gonna be a lot of parables. Damon, I like to first just, you saw this gap and you said, you know what, something needs to change. So tell me, what was like the first aha moment, right, about like Monolaurin, that you felt like, oh, you know what, this is something different, and this is something I should bring to the people, right, and expand its public exposure?
Yeah, it really, everything started with the research, right? It's too common to be seduced by marketing claims and the average influencer post that a certain product is going to cure something, right? And that's rarely the case. Frankly, personal health choices are a combination of lifestyle choices that stem from diet, exercise, mental health, sleeping, and supplements can be a part of that overall combination. But what I wanted to do was shy away from fads and trends and look to see what the research was saying. And so there's a fascinating government website called NCBI or PubMed, and it's run by the National Institutes of Health. It functions very similarly to Google. You go to PubMed and there's a search bar, and you're able to plug in a search term and you'll get results from a database of hundreds of thousands, maybe millions of scholarly and academic articles. And but not for the faint of heart. You definitely have to do a lot of slogging through lots of Latin-sounding words and formulas, but it's a really, really great resource for the gold standard of clinical research. So, double-blind, placebo-controlled, multi-center studies. And that's where we started, right? We said, okay, for immune health, for supporting and maintaining overall immune health, like what is the research saying? And what really rose to the top was the lauric acid research, also known as Monolaurin. And I encourage people listening to this podcast today to go to PubMed yourself and take a peek, because again, it works just like Google. You can put in the search term lauric acid or monolaurin and any sort of modifier that you're interested in, whether it's digestive health, right? Skin health, any modifier that you think would be particularly interesting to you as an individual, you can make those combinations, look for those results and start reading the peer-reviewed research right there. And that's exactly where we got started. There are hundreds of results when searching for monolaurin, and it just got me down this rabbit hole and engaging, people in the field to see, you know, what's behind this substance.
That's interesting to know. PubMed, I've never heard of that until now. So thank you for teaching me that. So I'm going to do a slight layman whistle. And I think I just want to make sure, because there's a lot of research out there in the world, right? And then there's research and then there's actual research, right? So you said double blinded, placebo controlled research. And I think it's important for our listeners who aren't, you know, the medical geniuses out there to understand like what that means from a research perspective, and why is that different from a poor research, right? Because especially with the world we live in today, right? There's research and then there's real research. So Doc Mock, you want to take that away?
Absolutely. And I would encourage all of you to keep this as a part of your good practices anytime you're starting to implement some sort of diet lifestyle supplement as a part of your universe, is to go to PubMed and start to look at things. And if you need any help, we are just an email away at team@maximalbean.com. When I prepare for my podcast, that's where I go first. You can also PubMed me and look up my publications. And quick plug there. We're also
subtle flex. Subtle flex. Yeah. Let's go. Subtle flex.
We just published the novel technique for small bowel cancers. So look out for that in the journals. But anyway, double blinded placebo controlled trials are the gold standard. And I would say, kind of a side to that, are systematic reviews and meta-analyses using a kind of a protocol that's like standardized. But what this means, Jackie, is that any study that you do has within it some sort of bias, right? So you take a pill, you know this pill is going to cure your cancer, right? And so theoretically, the power of our brains can overtake our physiology. And you can see what's called the placebo effect, where even if I give you a salt tablet, you're going to see some sort of clinical benefit if you believe that that is what is going to give you benefit. So therefore, when we're controlling for something like a lauric acid, we give people a placebo on the other end to see, is it the lauric acid that's making the difference, or is it just the power of suggestion? Then the whole concept of randomization. So, you know, who gets the placebo pill? Who gets the lauric acid pill? So we use random number generators, envelopes, all these things to make sure that there's a mixed group of people that is getting one intervention versus the other. So that way we can generalize it to people across all ethnic backgrounds, across all sexes. And if you look at early research, like say from the 1960s, a lot of these people are white and a lot of these people are men. And so it's hard to generalize a lot of that information to other sort of populations. And thankfully, the world of science has moved away from those biases and towards, you know, randomization and a diverse patient population. So back to you, Jackie. Hopefully that expanded on things.
That was great, Doc Mock. You're the best.
Back at you,
thank you.
What's going on, Maximal Beings? It's Doc Mock here. Many of you are returning to the gym now, but some are not going back. Regardless of what you plan, Rogue has got the right gear to fit your needs. I personally own a barbell set and love it. The black op shorts are sweat resistant and flexible for getting deep in your squats. Head on over to MaximalBeing.com/Rogue for our referral link. Order 3 items and they ship for free. And as usual, it's Doc Mock, and I'm here to maximize your pathway to wellness. If you're stuck at home and cannot make it to the grocery store, delivery may be the best way to stay clean and healthy. Instacart is the national leader in the direct-to-home delivery service. With numerous major chains and food from smaller stores, you can get those local veggies sent directly to your doorstep. Head on over to MaximalBeing.com/Instacart and maximize your nutrition today.
Damon, you went into PubMed, you searched, I'm assuming you spent hours and hours and hours, right? Look at this through this research, right, of lauric acid, right? So tell me, what were some of your findings, right? And of course, right, we're not making any claims here, right? Like, you know, it's not the special magic bullet that's going to cure everything, but what would you say were some suggestions of how it impacted someone's health or from a cosmetic standpoint?
Yeah, that's great, Jackie. And it wasn't just me, it was a team of us. I had engaged several industry professionals, both MDs and PharmDs and PhDs. So I really wanted the best to look through this and look at it with a critical eye to all the studies, because you're right, there's a lot of stuff out there that may not be, you know, gold standard type research, and we wanted to really pay attention to the best. But the research is far-reaching. A couple more Latin words for you. There are in vitro and in vivo studies out there, which means in the body or in the laboratory. And I'm sure Doc Mock will be very pleased to expand on those definitions in a bit. But look, the research was fascinating because, yes, it uses, there are human studies, animal subject studies, and also, you know, in vitro studies, and they all explored the application of lauric acid and monolaurin on various pathogens, I guess, and other things that could make an individual sick. And while I can't get into specifics about the results and the types of studies here, just to be very, very conscious of compliance obligations, the results were fascinating, right? Some of the subjects were given lauric acid before given a treatment, some after, and the results were really powerful enough to warrant further exploration and indeed, sort of standing up an entire product line based on this product and what the research is suggesting. And the research goes back several decades, actually, ironically, to the 1960s. So hopefully the subjects weren't all white males. But the research does go back quite a few years. And that gave us a great peace of mind, right? Because lauric acid is listed on the FDA's GRAS list. So GRAS is an acronym, which stands for generally recognized as safe. And so the FDA permits its use in not just dietary supplements, but in all types of food and cosmetic manufacturing. I think you touched on cosmetics. So it's used as a surfactant and a shelf stabilizer for cosmetics. It's used in food production and things like ice cream and pastas. And indeed, it's even sprayed on the outsides of fruits and vegetables to help with the transport of fruits and vegetables to help aid. And again, you know, making sure that they reach their destination really fresh. And it wasn't until recently that the sort of the uptake for monolaurin and lauric acid has found its way into the supplement space. But it's really, really gotten a lot of attention here. I think according to Google Trends, searches for monolaurin have been up over 300% year over year. And for good cause, I think.
What's going on, Maximal Beings? Doc Mock here. If you haven't done so already, leave us a comment and hit the subscribe button. Let your friends and family know. That way we can get the word out and continue to bash the bro science.